Class 5 IMO Level 2. Mathematics question number 31. Naman left the town P at time shown below. After 1 hour 50 minutes, he stopped at town Q for rest. He then took another 2 hours 25 minutes to reach town R. How long was his break? Naman left the town P at time 10:55. Naman reached the town R at time 5. Total time of travel plus break is equal to 6 hours 5 minutes. Time taken only for travels is equal to 1 hour 50 minutes plus 2 hours 25 minutes, that is 4 hours 15 minutes. Total time taken for break is equal to total time taken for travel with break minus time taken for travel, that is 1 hour 50 minutes. Mathematics question number 32. The sum of 4 numbers is 598. The second number is 78 more than the first number. The third number is 25 more than the second number. If the fourth number is 38 less than the third number, then what is the first number? Let the numbers be n1, n2, n3 and n4. Given n2 is equal to n1 plus 78. N3 is equal to N1 plus 78 plus 25, that is N1 plus 103. N4 is equal to N1 plus 65. And N1 plus N2 plus N3 plus N4 is equal to 598. So N1 plus N2 can be written as N1 plus 78. So N1 plus 78 plus N3 can be written as N1 plus 103. Plus N4 can be written as N1 plus 65. So using this, we can find the value of N1. So N1 is equal to 88, which is the first number. Mathematics question number 33. The figure given below, not drawn to scale, is made up of a rectangle and two squares. DE is half as long as DG. If BC is equal to 14, EF is equal to 16, and HI is equal to 10, then find the length of HF. Now, let's first write the values that are given in the question. Here they have said that if EF is equal to 16, then DG is equal to 16. Given DE is half as DG, half of DG is 8. So DE is equal to 8. Then GF is also 8 cm. Since DEFG is a rectangle, GHIJ is a square. If HI is 10 cm, then HG is also 10 cm. So HG is equal to FG plus FH. That is 10 centimeters. So now we know one value, that is 8 centimeters plus FH is equal to 10. Using this, we can find the value of FH, that is 2. Mathematics question number 34. The angle X in the given clock is an obtuse angle. Mathematics question number 35. The number name in international system of numeration for the sum of numbers on the given two abacus is. The sum of the given two abacus is 735,645. Mathematics question number 36. Which of the following squares must be shaded so that the given figure has a line of symmetry? As we can see here, if we put this way diagonal symmetry, we have to shade all of these boxes. But if we put it in the other way around, we have to shade only one box. That is Roman letter 1. Mathematics question number 37. Manish drew a line segment of length 51 cm. He accidentally erased 3 by 5 of the line segment. What is the remaining length of the line segment? Length of line segment is equal to 51 cm. Manish erased 3 by 5 of the line segment. Therefore, remaining is equal to 2 by 5. So, 2 by 5 of 51 is equal to 204 mm. Mathematics question number 38. The value of the given Roman numeric expression. The value of the given numeric expression is equal to 2621. Mathematics question number 39. A football team is planning a trip to the beach where they will spend the nights in tents. If each tent can hold 3 players, then which of the following tables correctly shows the number of tents needed for different number of players? Given one tent can hold 3 people. Here, the number of players are 12, 18, 21 and 33. If we divide every number by 3, we can get the number of tents needed, that is 4, 6, 7 and 11. Mathematics question number 40. Which of the following is true? Number of unshaded squares in P is equal to 24 1 by 2. Area of unshaded square P is equal to 98 square units. And area of unshaded is Q is equal to 64 square units. Now, by looking at this, we can easily say that unshaded area of P is greater than unshaded area of Q. Mathematics question number 41. Divya bought 10 liters of milk. She poured the milk equally into 7 containers. There was 0.20 liters of milk left. What was the volume of milk in each container? The total amount of milk Divya bought is equal to 10 liters. She poured milk into 7 equal containers and the remaining amount is 0.20 liters. Therefore, she poured 10 minus 0.2, that is 9.8 liters equally into 7 containers. So, volume of each container is equal to 9.8 divided by 7, 1.40 liters. Mathematics question number 42. If 3 triangles plus 2 pentagon is equal to 108 and 1 triangle 2 pentagon is equal to 64, then what is triangle minus pentagon? From equation 2, we can write that triangle is equal to 64 minus 2 pentagon, that is equation 3. Substituting the value of triangle in equation 1, we can find the value of pentagon, that is 21. Substituting the value of pentagon in equation 3, we can get the value of triangle, that is 22. Therefore, triangle minus pentagon is equal to 22 minus 21, that is 1. Mathematics question number 43. Kanak paid a down payment of 2,20,000 for a car. She then paid a monthly installment of 9,800.5 rupees for 72 months. Find the total amount she paid for the car. Down payment made by Kanak is equal to 2,20,000. Total monthly installment paid by her is equal to 9,800.5 rupees into 72 because it's 72 months. So therefore, 7,05,636 is the monthly installment paid by her. Total amount she paid for the car is equal to 2,20,000 plus 7,05,636 is equal to 9,25,636. Mathematics question number 44. Count the number of acute angles formed in the given figure. Now first let us name these rays. The number of acute angles formed in the given figure will be more than 7. Mathematics question number 45. The difference between the successor and predecessor of the number shown on the given abacus is? Number shown on the given abacus is 6,13,523. Successor is obtained by adding 1 to the number and the predecessor is obtained by subtracting 1 from the number. So difference between the predecessor and successor is equal to 1 plus 1, that is 2. In general, the difference between the successor and predecessor of any number is always 2. That's it for this video. Make sure to subscribe. Hit that like button, turn on post notifications so that you guys never miss out on a video that I upload. And I'll see y'all next time. Goodbye.